Where's the design people? What's going on? Where's the makeup artist? When you think of Antarctica, do you think of a cold, remote, vast, untouched, icy wilderness? Or vast penguin colonies, iconic seals, albatross, and the giant whales of the Southern Ocean? Both are true for me, but I also think of the small and rare pockets of ice-free land on the coast of the Antarctic continent where rock and soil are exposed. These oases in the dry Antarctic desert, and yes, they are oases, are surrounded by ice and cover less than 0.5% of the whole of the Antarctic continent. They are some of the most unique and extreme environments on the Earth and where most of Antarctica's life is found. Unlike most regions in the world, there are no trees, there are no shrubs in Antarctica. The vast majority of vegetation in Antarctica are very small and slow-growing mosses and lichens, as well as microscopic algae. These are the miniature forests of Antarctica. The tallest plant is only a few millimetres high. The plants and the soil are home to thousands of different microbes and to a range of tiny critters that are barely visible to the human eye and have rarely been seen by most people. While they're not large and charismatic like whales and penguins, they're incredibly important for soil health and they're alluring in their own way. They are the real life at the extremes. To me, these tiny creatures, the rotifers, nematodes and tardigrades, commonly known as water bears or moss piglets, are pretty amazing. These tough little creatures are so well adapted that they can effectively shut down, remaining dormant when the soil dries or freezes or when food is scarce, often for years at a time. This enables them to survive and indeed thrive in such an extreme place. While most of Antarctica's coast is ice shelves and cliffs with glaciers plummeting into the sea, right next to the coastal pockets of land is where you'll find shallow waters teeming with many unique and often bizarre marine organisms. From sea urchins up to a century old to massive sea sponges, fish with antifreeze in their blood, forests of fast-growing kelp, and sea spiders bigger than my hand. It's the most wondrous and beautiful place with the clearest of waters under the ice. And so much there remains unexplored and is not well understood. While some of the species in Antarctica we see elsewhere in the world, many are endemic. That means they occur only in Antarctica or even in just a small area in Antarctica. So if we lose them, they are gone forever. So here's the challenge. All of this diversity of life is occurring where most human activities also happen in Antarctica. Australia has 3 permanent research stations in Antarctica, and there are more than 70 stations built by 30 nations around the continent. Such a strong human presence puts pressure on the surrounding ecosystems, making them vulnerable to impacts and change. And of course, like everywhere else in the world, these ecosystems are also vulnerable to global climate change. So this is what our team of scientists in the Environmental Protection Program at the Australian Antarctic Division focus on. Firstly, we look at what is there, why is it so special, and what are the threats? And then we ask the really big questions. What can we do about it? How can we better protect and conserve Antarctica's biodiversity? And how can we repair past environmental damage? Because where human activities occur, where people and infrastructure are concentrated, some habitats have become degraded. For more than 0.5 century, waste and contamination has built up in Antarctica. Our vision is for a cleaner Antarctica, and it's our job and our responsibility to clean up this pollution. The critical work that scientists in our program do provides data and robust scientific evidence to inform environmental policies and management. Over the past 20 years, Australia has led research on the impacts of human activities in Antarctica. We have worked out ways to clean up cocktails of contaminants at old rubbish tip sites and how to stop non-native species hitchhiking with us to Antarctica. Our team has also shown one of the very best ways to clean up soil contaminated with fuel in Antarctica is by encouraging the native microbes that live there to actually eat the fuel. So at Casey Research Station, we've designed and built a luxury dirt hotel to boost the appetite of tiny pollution-munching microbes. It's home to billions of native microorganisms. This mega biopile is the largest bioremediation construction in Antarctica, measuring 20 metres wide by 40 metres long and holding around 750 cubic metres of contaminated soil that will be cleaned up before we return it to the environment. So we develop this science and we engineer the technologies and tools and then we use them on site. And through the Antarctic Treaties Committee for Environmental Protection, we provide advice to other nations on what we have learned also. But we still have much to do. There is a legacy of pollution and waste from the 1950s and 60s. Our vision is to lead by example in cleaning up Antarctica, to avoid pollution in the first place, and to fix up environmental problems if they occur. If we are going to look after Antarctica, we have to look after those oases of life. Be enough? Yeah, a few things enough? For more stories from the Australian Antarctic Program, please like and subscribe and share our videos with your friends.